हाय फ्रेंड्स, गुड इवनिंग, वेलकम टू शंकरन एआई स्टडी सर्कल. दिस इज डॉक्टर हरिनाथ रेड्डी, डायरेक्टर ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट. टुडे इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो वी विल ट्राई टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया, हाउ ए सिंगल मेंबर इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया बिकेम ए मल्टी मेंबर इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया, दैट वी विल डिस्कस. सो इन द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन आर्टिकल 324 Article 324 deals with Election Commission of India and the superintendence, direction and control of elections to the Parliament, state legislatures, to the office of the President and Vice President. So in India, starting from 26th January 1950 till 16th October 1989, so 26th January 1950 till 16th October 1989, Election Commission of India functioned as a single member body. Election Commission of India functioned as a single member body. But subsequently, when Rajiv Gandhi was the Prime Minister of India, he had differences with Gnani Jail Singh, the then President of India. And as all of you know, with respect to the Indian Post Office Amendment Bill, the only instance of the use of pocket veto was done by Gnani Jail Singh. So, when Peri Shastri was the Chief Election Commissioner, to prevent Gnani Jail Singh contesting for the second time to the office of the President, in that particular issue, there were disagreements between Rajiv Gandhi as the Prime Minister and the Chief Election Commissioner, who is Peri Shastri by then. And keeping that in mind, 2 years before the elections were due to the 9th Lok Sabha, Rajiv Gandhi had a fear in his mind that Peri Shastri may act unilaterally and that might create a trouble to his government. So keeping that in mind, October 7th, 1989, the single member election commission of India was made a multi-member election commission of India by the President through a notification. On October 7, 1989, the President had issued a notification. On the basis of this notification, on October 16, 1989, two new election commissioners were appointed in addition to the Chief Election Commissioner, who is Peri Shastri by this time. So this was S.S. Dhanoya and V.S. Segal. So Peri Shastri was the Chief Election Commissioner and the remaining two Central Election Commissioners are S.S. Dhanoya, V.S. Segal. Subsequently, so Election Commission of India functioned as a multi-member body from October 16, 1989 for the next only 70 days. So when Election Commission of India became a multi-member body for the first time on October 16, 1989, it has functioned as a multi-member body for 70 days. Subsequently, after the elections to the 9th Lok Sabha were over, V.P. Singh became the Prime Minister of India. Under the notification which was issued by the earlier government was done away with. And as a result, S.S. Dhanoya and Segal were removed as the Central Election Commissioners. And one of these two Central Election Commissioners, S.S. Dhanoya, he went to the Supreme Court and filed a case. And this case is known as S.S. Dhanoya versus Union of India. S.S. Dhanoya versus Union of India. This is the case. So the removal of the two Central Election Commissioners by V.P. Singh government was challenged before the Supreme Court in a case known as S.S. Dhanoya versus Union of India. In this case, the Supreme Court has dismissed the petition filed by S.S. Dhanoya, arguing that the President has unfettered, unlimited powers with respect to the appointment as well as the removal of the Central Election Commissioners, and so the petition was dismissed. And then subsequently, Election Commission of India continued as a single member body for almost 4 years, 16th October 1989 to October 2nd, 1993. So 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, for almost 4 years Election Commission of India continued as again a single member body. From October 16, 1989, it functioned for 70 days as a multi-member body, and subsequently till October 2nd, 1993, it functioned as a single member body. So Peri Shastri, the then Chief Election Commissioner, he died while he is in office. V.S. Ramadevi, she served as the Chief Election Commissioner temporarily, and in the meantime a permanent Chief Election Commissioner was appointed, and the person who is appointed is a T.N. Seshan. So T.N. Seshan had a differences with the then Prime Minister P.V. Narasimha Rao. So P.V. Narasimha Rao was worried about the independent and unilateral behavior on the part of the then Chief Election Commissioner T.N. Seshan. So again, through an ordinance, the single member election commission of India was made a multi member body on October 2nd, 1993. So the two new central election commissioners who were appointed by this time, it was MS Gill GVG Krishnamurthy. And then subsequently what happened is in 1991 there was a law enacted by the Indian Parliament, the Chief Election Commissioner and other election commissioners, Conditions of Service Act 1991. According to this legislation made by the Indian Parliament, the Chief Election Commissioner was given the status of a judge of Supreme Court. Under the retirement age of the Chief Election Commissioner was fixed at 65 years. Then when it came to the two central election commissioners, they were given the status of the judge of the High Court, and their retirement age was fixed at 62 years. Subsequently, in 1993, through an ordinance made by the then government headed by P.V. Narasimha Rao as the Prime Minister, amended the 1991 Act. So the 1991 law made by the Indian Parliament was amended by P.V. Narasimha Rao government through an ordinance in 1993. And what is the amendment? So this amendment has made the status of the Chief Election Commissioner on par with the remaining two Central Election Commissioners. So that's the reason why, because of the amendment which was done in 1993, the two Central Election Commissioners, they enjoyed the same status with the Chief Election Commissioner like the judge of the Supreme Court. All the three were given the status of the judge of the Supreme Court, and for all the three the retirement age is fixed at 65. Even in terms of powers, all the three were given equal powers, and in case of disagreement between the three, the decision will be taken by majority. So this ordinance, this amendment was challenged before the Supreme Court in a case known as T.N. Seshan, the Chief Election Commissioner versus Union of India, 1995. So in this case, T.N. Seshan has argued giving the other two Central Election Commissioner the same status and the same powers like the Chief Election Commissioner has affected the powers of the Chief Election Commissioner. So the Supreme Court did not agree with T.N. Seshan. His petition was dismissed, and the powers of the two Central Election Commissioners when it comes to versus the Chief Election Commissioner, the Supreme Court said in terms of status and powers, the two other Central Election Commissioners enjoy the same status and powers like the Chief Election Commissioner. In addition to this, the Supreme Court also said, if the Election Commission of India becomes a multi-member body, with the remaining two central election commissioners enjoying the same status and powers like the chief election commissioner. It will further strengthen the institution of Election Commission of India, its autonomy and independence in the working. So with this, from then onwards, Election Commission of India continued to be a multi-member body. So this is the story of how a single member Election Commission of India became a multi-member Election Commission of India. In addition, in the next video, we will try to discuss about the recommendations to strengthen the institution of Election Commission of India. So in the recent past, when the elections were conducted to the Legislative Assembly of West Bengal, there were allegations that the Election Commission of India has acted in a partisan manner. So in that context, what are all the things which need to be done to make the institution of Election Commission of India much more autonomous and independent? That we will discuss in a separate video in the next class. Thank you.